Welcome to the International Jobs and Economic Development Impact, or JEDI, Tool Web Tutorial. This tutorial is brought to you by the Enhancing Capacity for Low Emission Development Strategies, EC-LEDS, program. EC-LEDS works with more than 25 partner countries to accelerate their transition to a sustainable future and implement their nationally determined contributions. By the end of this tutorial, you will be able to understand how the I-JEDI model can help you achieve your development objectives, describe an input-output model, and use the I-JEDI model and interpret results. During this tutorial, we'll introduce the I-JEDI tool, explain input-output models, describe I-JEDI in more detail, demonstrate how to input data and interpret results, and explain some important caveats. Economic impact assessment is an important part of objective analysis, that is, analysis that is not based on opinion. Governments can often point to such analyses when evaluating project options. These types of analyses can also be cited when communicating project benefits to the public. The I-JEDI tool can help with objective analysis. JEDI stands for Jobs and Economic Development Impact. JEDI was first developed by the National Renewable Energy Laboratory in 2004. You can use JEDI to estimate the economic impacts of the construction and operation of electricity generation and biofuel plants on the economy of a given region, typically a country. There are 16 Excel-based models currently available encompassing renewable energy technologies, such as wind, solar thermal and PV, geothermal and hydro, as well as fossil fuel technologies. NREL has a web version of the tool that is designed to model solar PV plants. I-JEDI is the international version of the JEDI tool. It estimates economic impacts from biomass, wind, solar PV, and geothermal plants. Currently, I-JEDI can be used out of the box to perform analysis in South Africa, Colombia, Mexico, the Philippines, and Zambia. I-JEDI is designed to accept economic information from other regions to customize the model. This allows users to perform analysis on any region of the world. Now let's discuss the background of the model. I-JEDI uses the input-output method to calculate the effects of renewable energy developments in the economy of a region as a whole. Most economic activities have effects on other industries or sectors of the economy. Take the example of a car maker. A manufacturer needs to buy parts from different suppliers. In this example, we see that a car maker would buy headlights, tires, and screws from other suppliers. These purchases have an economic effect on the suppliers of headlights, tires, and screws. The input-output model calculates the effects that an economic activity may have on the rest of a regional economy as a whole. The social accounting matrix represents the economic impacts that each sector of the economy has on the others. In the table shown, manufacturing produces 1,500 economic units, measured in, say, millions of dollars, for the agricultural sector in a given economy. It could be the economy of a country, a province, or a municipality. In the demand or final use column, we see that manufacturing produces 1,000 units for end consumers for a gross production of 4,000 units. Gross production includes production for final and intermediate consumers. The input-output model uses data from the social accounting matrix to estimate the effect of a certain stimulus, in the case of I-JEDI, the construction and operation of a power plant, in the rest of the economy. Mathematically, the input-output model can be expressed as an equation that uses the direct effects of an economic activity, represented by the D matrix, to calculate the effects on each of the sectors of the rest of the economy, represented by the X matrix. Each variable in the D and X matrices represents one sector of the economy. Next, we'll discuss the model inputs and demo its use. The inputs that I-JEDI requires include construction costs and operations and maintenance costs. I-JEDI also needs to know the percentage of expenses made within the region of interest. I-JEDI contains default costs for the five countries mentioned earlier: South Africa, Zambia, Mexico, Colombia, and the Philippines. The model is also designed to accept custom cost data from any region in the world, including updated information for the five default countries. Now, let's demo how to add these inputs into the model. First, note that at any point, you can click on the question mark to go to the help sheet. I-JEDI has four input sheets, one for each technology: wind, solar PV, biopower, and geothermal. In this example, we'll model a wind project. The input sheet structure is the same for all projects, so these instructions will apply to other input sheets as well. At the top of the project input sheet, we select the country of analysis. In this demo, we'll select South Africa. The next input is project size in megawatts. Changing the project size changes project costs in the cells below. For this example, we'll use 250 megawatts. I-JEDI's default input costs are in $2014. By changing the value of the dollar year, I-JEDI's default input costs are adjusted for inflation. In this cell, the user selects the dollar year in which they want to express the results. We'll select 2015 as our dollar year. I-JEDI contains default cost data to facilitate its use to first-time users. Default data can be overwritten by users who have more up-to-date data. The Update with Wind Defaults button restores default values that have been overwritten. Macros must be enabled for this button to work. Costs are entered in two categories. At the top, we see plant construction costs, which are one-time expenses. And at the bottom, we see operations and maintenance costs, which are annual, ongoing costs. The values in the black boxes can be modified. The values in column B represent the total costs per item, as described in the corresponding cell in column A, for a plant of the size specified in cell B5. The values in column C represent the percentage of those costs paid to entities within the region of analysis. In this case, South Africa. For example, if we think that roughly half of the turbines will be sourced from within South Africa and the rest from one or more foreign countries, we'll input 50% in cell C13. If we click on the cells within the black borders, we'll see that the data comes from the default data sheet. If the user has data that differs from the default data, the user can replace them, like we did with the percentage of the turbines purchased from within South Africa. In this example, we'll change the total cost of the turbines to $200 million. Before looking at the wind results sheet, let's talk about the I-JEDI results and their structure. I-JEDI provides results of five types in three categories, as well as total results. The types of results are number of jobs, total earnings, economic output, and value added. Value added is another term for gross domestic product. Total earnings include the earnings of all the jobs supported by the project, as expressed in the jobs column. The three result categories correspond to direct, indirect, and induced impacts. We'll review more information about the three categories of impacts shortly. Combining the four types and three categories of results gives us a matrix of 12 cells. Before we take another look at the result matrices, let's talk about direct, indirect, and induced impacts. Direct impacts refer to immediate impacts associated with expenses from the project we're analyzing. Examples include labor and equipment, as well as design, construction, installation, and utility expenses. In the car manufacturer example we looked at before, direct impacts would include salaries to workers and money spent to purchase the other components, like headlights, tires, and screws. Indirect impacts are money spent on all the goods or services needed to provide direct goods and services. In a car manufacturing plant, indirect impacts would include the money that the tire manufacturer spends on rubber, or money that the headlight manufacturer spends on raw materials. An induced impact is one that results from expenses made by direct and indirect workers. So if an employee of the car manufacturer goes to lunch, the money she spends at the restaurant would be an induced impact. Remember, total results from construction phase activities are one time only. These jobs and their impacts end after construction is over. Operations phase jobs are continuous. Because these impacts differ, I-JEDI reports two sets of results, one from the construction phase and one from the operations phase. Both sets use the same result matrix. Now let's look at the results in the I-JEDI spreadsheet. First, if we go back to the inputs sheet, you can either click on the arrow at the bottom to go to results, or you can click directly on the results sheet. Remember, at any point, you can click on the question mark to go to the help sheet. The results sheet shows the same tables that we saw on the previous slides. The columns show the four types of results: number of jobs supported, earnings, economic output, and value added, also known as gross domestic product. Dividing earnings by the number of jobs would give us the average earnings for each job supported. The rows show the three categories of results: direct, indirect, and induced, plus a row totaling the numbers. The matrix on top shows results for the construction phase and the one below, O&M results. Scrolling down, you see the same construction results, except that they're more granularly disaggregated by industry, such as agriculture, mining and extraction, utilities, and more. Further down the sheet, you see operations and maintenance results for the same industries. This is just the example for wind, but the inputs and results sheets for solar PV, biopower, and geothermal work in the same way. Now let's discuss some important caveats. I-JEDI doesn't evaluate project economic feasibility. The model won't tell you whether the project will make money. Second, JEDI results are gross. New economic activity can displace other activities. For example, a worker at a wind power plant may work at a car manufacturer in absence of the wind power plant. Next, I-JEDI results are linear. For example, the impact per watt of a big plant will be different than the impact per watt of a small plant because of economies of scale. I-JEDI does not currently take this into consideration. For example, if you have 100 1-megawatt projects or one 100-megawatt project, JEDI will give you the same results. Conversely, if you have one plant that is 10 megawatts and you want to model an 80-megawatt system instead, you can either change the inputs or just multiply the results by 8. Next, I-JEDI results provide a snapshot in time. In reality, new renewable energy plants may have market and policy impacts and other effects. For example, as the market for renewable energy expands in a certain region, the supply chain may become more efficient in general, and prices may decline as a consequence. JEDI results are static. They do not reflect policy or market impacts. Lastly, remember that NREL is not responsible for user results or subsequent decisions. Thank you for joining this web tutorial. For more information on I-JEDI, download it at the link on your screen. You can also download the I-JEDI User Guide in English and Spanish, and you can always contact JEDI support.